Welcome to Hyfindr Expo Highlights. I'm Steven, and today I'm with Todd from Phinia. Todd, thanks for coming.
Thanks, Steven.
And I understand you're presenting some innovations here today. Can you tell us about them, please?
Yes. At Phinia, we provide fuel injection systems and components, solutions for the industry. Mm-hmm. We've been doing that for centuries.
All right.
And we have centuries experience in that. And we've been taking that competency and knowledge and moving toward hydrogen as a zero CO2 fuel to power our vehicles of today.
So that means you have been building and selling, obviously, injectors for diesel
and gasoline.
Engines. Okay, so
yes.
Like the one we have here.
Yes.
And now you have modified them in such a way that they also work for hydrogen. Is this correct? Okay.
Maybe I could share an example
here. Yes, please, with pleasure.
We have a product for a gasoline direct inject.
Yes.
Injection. Unit, and it is used in many vehicles around the world today for gasoline direct inject.
This one as we see here?
Correct.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. And so with this background and competency, mm-hmm. we've taken that experience mm-hmm. and modified the materials and the internal working to be able to make an direct injector that will inject hydrogen for zero CO2 fuel in an internal combustion engine.
So just to understand, this is almost the same dimensions as I see as the other one, and it's injecting hydrogen here at the nozzle into the end. Where does the hydrogen come in?
Correct. So the hydrogen comes in when this is inserted into the engine pocket.
Yeah.
And enters the injector and comes out through this, importantly, outward opening injector nozzle.
So this is injected into the engine.
Into the combustion chamber.
Into the this sits at the top of the piston.
Yes.
Chamber, basically.
Yes. The combustion In various configurations.
And the top, is this the entrance where the hydrogen comes in? Ah, okay, that's the feed. Okay, that is where it comes in, and this is essentially letting it through. And how much pressure are we talking about?
We have solutions for low pressure, which mm-hmm. would be less than 10 bar.
Yes.
And medium pressure, which our demonstrator vehicle is running on 30 bar mm-hmm. of pressure. And also solutions for high pressure on up north of 100 bar up to 300 bar for hydrogen.
So that means you will need, if you have a four-cylinder engine, you will need four of these.
Correct.
And what additionally would you use, and what is Phinia providing? Are you just focusing on the injectors?
Well, the injectors are a critical part of the fuel system, but also there's a pressure rail mm-hmm. That works with the injectors.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And importantly, our engine control unit will drive the injectors. They operate within milliseconds to deliver very precise amounts of fuel, with hydrogen being a gas, being able to control that injection into the combustion chamber is critical. We provide the software and the engine control unit hardware to be able to make that happen. Okay.
Do you have this in operation anywhere already?
We do. We have demonstrator vans. There's an example here.
Ah, right.
Mm-hmm. These have driven thousands of kilometers on public roadways.
These ones.
And we continue to move forward learning about the technology, but also putting it into operation.
So Todd, I know you're a technical guy, and this is technology which is obviously reducing the CO2 footprint. Can you just take us through what are there any exhaust fumes? And if not, I mean, you sitting at the injector point will know now.
Yes. So the interesting thing about hydrogen, there's no carbon in it.
Yes.
So at the tailpipe, there's virtually zero CO2. Less than the zero criteria impact emissions levels.
Yeah. Where would the C even come from if there is
exactly
in
hydrogen? It's not even there.
Okay. So that means this.
Now, if I may, there is NOx that's generated as a result of combustion.
Yeah.
But we have a system and an engine solution that results in that NOx being well below any emissions levels, even the proposed Euro 7 emission level, we are order of magnitude less than that.
Okay, than the Euro 7, which is for diesel and so on. Okay. Todd, thank you very much. Can you just give a small outlook? So obviously this, where can you give us an outlook? Where are you taking this to? Do you have plans? Will we see more injectors everywhere or what?
We will. Mm-hmm. At Phinia, we believe for us to achieve the global carbon neutrality goals, it will take all the technologies that we have. Mm-hmm. There's a place for battery electric vehicle. There's a place for hydrogen fuel cell. There's a place for hydrogen internal combustion engine. And as we take the best of all that technology, we can move forward. We can do that quickly using hydrogen internal combustion technology because it uses existing raw material sources, manufacturing footprints, distribution and service networks, mm-hmm. and also it maximizes the existing infrastructure, whether it's equipment or human capital.
Okay.
So we are advancing efficiencies today while we power toward a carbon-free tomorrow.
Okay. Thank you very much, Todd. Excellent. Thanks for coming over and thank you for watching. Subscribe to our channel to meet more people like Todd and have a good day. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Stephen. Thank you.
Thank you.